in and around Spartanburg County. She is current athletic director at Converse College in Spartanburg, where she has been for the past 9 years. In June 2007, shortly after she arrived at Converse, the school was granted full membership in the Conference Carolinas. As a member of the Division II Carolinas Virginia Athletic Conference, Converse competes at the highest NCAA level of any women's college in the nation. I've asked her to come today to share with you additional information about the college's athletic programs, as well as the college as a whole. And accompanying her today is her husband, Honorable Roger Couch, Circuit Judge of the Seventh Circuit, and a Rotarian, as I said previously, in the Spartanburg, Florida. Please join me in welcoming my good friend, Roger Couch.
We're full members of the Conference Carolinas, which means that, as Elizabeth said, we we compete at the highest level of any women's college in the nation, that we have the opportunity for our athletes to be recognized nationally, regionally, and in the conference for their accomplishments on the field of competition and academically. So it's a great opportunity for students, for women to come to Converse and to compete and to continue the things that they're most passionate about. When I went to Converse as the athletics director, I was totally blown away by the vision of Betsy Fleming, who is our at-home president, and her desire to grow an athletics program. She said to me, she said, "Joy, I believe that just like every man, every young girl coming out of high school deserves the opportunity to continue the things that they're passionate about, whether that be in field of music, leadership, or athletics. And at Converse, if our mission is to empower women, we have failed miserably in the area of athletics." So we began to grow the teams and the number of teams. And I want to say this. A lot of people say you just started growing and just picked and just made decisions based on whatever you want. But we took our time, did a lot of research, found out what girls today want to play, want to be involved with, and what our alumni supported. If our alumni were here, they would tell you that in the past, Converse was known for their equestrian program, which they had done away with a long time ago. We brought the equestrian program back. Converse has a pool that was built in the early 50s. It is still the pool that our athletes swim in today. And for years, that pool was not used for anything. So we looked at our program, our facilities, and we tried to choose things that would honor Converse, that would bring Converse-like students to our campus. So that's where we are today. And this fall, I'm proud to say that we're going to launch our 12th sport, which is acrobatics and tumbling. And in the fall, we will welcome over 200 student athletes to our campus. This is a total list of our athletics program. When I came there, we had basketball, cross country, soccer, tennis, and volleyball. All the others are new in additions to our campus. Being an athlete at Converse College, there are three things that we ask of you. We ask you to compete at the highest level that you can compete at on the field of competition. We ask you to be the best student that you can be in the classroom and represent the athletic program well. And then we believe that women in every community are the ones who have the innate desire to give back immediately. And we feel like that they need to learn to practice that. And so community involvement at Converse is tremendously important for our athletes. I could have chosen 15 or 20 things to show you of community engagements that have happened with our athletes this year. But I chose these four to talk to you just a little bit about. The Miracle League is a baseball league for underprivileged special needs children. And our teams choose days and go, and they're the buddies and the mentors and help get the students around the bases and help them play the game. We're involved in that all the time. We support a team, and a team wears the Valkyries on their jersey. We had two, at Converse, a lot of our students who are in education spend time going to the schools, the elementary schools, and reading and mentoring. So we had two lacrosse players who went to an elementary school at Converse, in Spartanburg, and began reading to them early in the year. They realized that the, the library there was in need of books, and a lot of the classrooms were in need of books. So at a lacrosse game, they did a E.P. Todd book drive, brought in over 1,000 books for that school to give those 6th, 7th grade. The Meeting Street Academy is a private school in Spartanburg for under resource families. And we brought them to our campus just a few weeks ago. Our tennis team did, and played tennis with them, taught them about tennis and tennis clinics. The picture on the top right is the group, so you can see how many students were there. Very excited and fun day on Converse's campus. And then our softball team, which is in its inaugural year, the first time these students have been on our campus. And this spring, they sponsored a pediatric cancer awareness softball game and brought lots of children who are suffering and going through the cancer and chemo and treatments to our softball game and recognized them and raised almost $1,000 for cancer awareness, pediatric cancer awareness. And while there are teams that are successful and spots of pride, there are also athletes that come to mind. Natalie Johnson's from England. She's a senior soccer player, and for the past 4 years, she's been someone on our campus that has grown and developed and given a lot to our community. Deja Adelaide is a junior from South Carolina who is a track, who runs and who was our first track athlete to be recognized in the conference as one of the top 4 athletes in her event. And she participated in the NCAA Student Leadership Forum in Phoenix, Arizona. She'd never been on a plane. It was quite an experience for her, but she came back on fire for becoming a leader in what she could be. Aubrey Lauderdale was one of the lacrosse students who was doing her internship at E.P. Todd and led the book drive. And then Cassie Morris is a junior from Anderson, South Carolina, who has a deep faith in Jesus Christ and was just determined that we have an active and vibrant Fellowship of Christian Athletes on our campus. So she got that started, and that didn't satisfy her. And Spartanburg is known as a college town. And she took off to all the other colleges in the area, and now we have a huge Fellowship of Christian Athletes collegiate ministry in Spartanburg. And she would tell you she didn't do it on her own, but I know one thing. She didn't quit talking about it until we all agreed that's what we were going to do. So, Converse Athletics is a source of pride on our campus. But Converse, because it's a women's college, and there are only 43 women's colleges left in the nation, and some of us who are older remember when it wasn't unusual to have women's colleges. And I always think Converse was founded in 1889 by Dexter Edgar Converse, who believed that women in our society needed an education and that we were only going to be as big a nation as successful as our women. Converse still is true to that mission. But in the fall of 2014, I was a part of a group on campus led by our president who believed that we should face and meet the trials and tribulations of higher education head on. And I believe it's because we have alumni that are a lot of important things, but most often, almost all of them end up being mothers who are totally dedicated to their children. and making decisions that are best for their children. And Converse looked at private education and realized that we were sending our graduates out into the world with so much debt that it would take years and years and years for them to pay that debt off. Not only that, then how could they provide for the education of their children? So that really was heavy on our hearts as an institution. And led by our president, we decided that we needed to do a reset. So Converse went from about $40,000 a year, and we just one day said, we're charging too much, we're going to charge exactly what it cost. And that was $26,000. That was in 2014, the fall of 2014. In the fall of 2016, the cost is going to be $26,750. So we are holding, we are totally, we don't make a price increase because that's what everyone else does. We only do it when we're forced to by situations on our campus, because we're committed that any woman who wants to get an education should be able to come to Converse and get an education and pay for it. We still have a lot of students who leave with loans and debt, but it's not $20,000 a year. And we're very proud of that. To back that up, we also believe that we know that students come with a first-year experience and make a decision early on that it's just too tough, they can't do it. In our first-year experience now, we put in our first-year dorms, freshman dorms, we have pods where they have tutors and leadership and campus supporters on that, right in there with them, so that they can come in and connect and make a real connection early on and have the opportunity to be successful and see themselves as a successful student at Converse. I'll keep moving along. You should get me started talking about Converse and I can talk forever. These are our new academic programs. As I've been around talking to people today, several of these have come up. The Pinky School of Music has been a pride of Converse for many, many years. We've realized that not only do we need to teach people to sing and teach people to play, but we need to teach them, because such a small percentage of those people who come are going to be able to have a career in performing, that we need to teach them the business of music, so that if they can't be a performer, they can still stay in the area they love and be in the business side of it. Look at these pictures. As we've done all this other stuff, we've also built and groomed and repurposed areas of our campus. The top picture is the picture of the Heath, which is our apartment housing. The picture right under that is the Marsh A. Gibbs Fieldhouse, which is my source of pride, the spot of pride, my happy place. We have the Betty Jackson Montgomery Rose Garden, the Barnett Commons, the Johnson Plaza, and we've not expanded our campus at all. We're still the same, I don't know, somebody that knows, tell me, 75 acres or something? If you know anything about Converse, Pell and Dexter have been our residence halls. They've been around a long time. If you walked to them, you'd know exactly where they were. If you walked inside, you wouldn't recognize them at all. Very updated, and our students love it. We continue to improve the technology in our classrooms and performance venues. I picked these out because I thought these were very important. 95% of people, of our students who graduate from Converse, graduate in 4 years. Now, if you have students who have been in college lately, I have a son who I was proud when he graduated in 6. But keep you on track, and we do. We've been very successful. The class of 2015, 58% were either employed in their desired field. Employment, I was glad they highlighted that. But desired field, I thought, was just as important. Or they were graduate school accepted upon graduation. 54% participated in research, and 40% participated in internships. And of that class, 40% of those people were self-identified as first generation, which means they're the first person in their family to get a degree from a, or to get a degree from a four-year school. And we continue to grow. Tuition reset's been good to us, but even before that, over the past 4 years, Converse has, I knew we couldn't do it. Over the past 4 years, Converse undergraduate enrollment has increased on an average of 30% every year. And we celebrate the largest enrollments in 25 years. Now. We're very pleased and excited. The leadership Betsy Fleming has provided our campus has been phenomenal. Coming to campus July 1st will be our 10th president, Krista Newkirk. And we have a new chairman of our board, who is a Commerce alumna, year 97, Kim Kent. And I know that Bentonville is not really close to Converse, so to say, come on over and visit campus is probably not something you're going to do this afternoon. But I would like to encourage you to keep up with us on converse.edu, or I know you're all excited about athletics now and you can't wait to see what's going on. We have a new website, govalkyries.com, and for us, don't go anywhere without a smartphone. We have a mobile app that you can keep up with the games as they're going on. It's been a pleasure to be here, and I want to tell you that Elizabeth McNeil has become one of my dearest friends, and it's all been brought about because of our love for Converse and our vision for what Converse could be. If you have any questions, I'll be happy to answer them.
What is your enrollment?
Our enrollment right now is 850 undergraduates, and about total with graduate programs, probably about 1,400. Graduate students don't go straight through. They sort of come in and out. It just kind of depends on the day you're counting.
We have graduate programs in music and education.
Music and education and creative writing. And family and their We do have community students, and day students are a growing population in all at all institutions. However, at Converse, in order to be a community student, you have to live within 30 miles of the campus. If you live more than 30, you have to. We're Division II, so we offer a dollar amount, and we spread that out all over the place. So we have students who play to get no money. We have students that play to get $1,000. And we have students that play to get $10,000 to $15,000.
Any other questions? I've got one question, but before I do, I just wanted to say to everybody else that when your husband Roger was running for the circuit judgeship, he had a secret weapon because he bring you over to the state house. I don't know any other judge candidate in the state that had such a really outgoing effect. spouse. But he's very lucky.
I'm lucky, man.
But my question is, what is a Valkyrie?
A Valkyrie is a Norse goddess who rides over, and this came because we are so entrenched in our in the school of music. And if you know Wagner's Ride of the Valkyrie, you know Peter Rabbit, the Kill Rabbit, anyway, that's what he does. Rides over the battlefield, gathers. Oh, Bunny, okay.
That's in my territory now.
Okay. Man, why don't you tell him to sing for me? Rides over the battlefield, gathers the most valiant warriors, and takes them to Valhalla, where they restore them to health, and they can abide this Norse goddess, long blonde hair, wearing the sword and shield, forever.
Right.
And that sounds interesting. It really does. I mean, if I have a minute, we did this like American Idol. We said, first of all, tell us anything you think we should be. When I went there, we were the Converse All-Stars. I had not been in the job 30 days when we got a letter from Nike. That was at the time the Nike bought Converse, that said, we're so excited that y'all are the All-Stars. Please send us the contract that shows that that Converse gave you the rights to use the All-Stars. Well, I very quickly found out that Converse didn't have a contract for the rights. So we decided it might be in our best interest to give up on the All-Star and become something we could be. So we threw out all the inappropriate things that were suggested, and we started voting. And we narrowed it to three or four choices.
Did the students vote?
That everybody voted. Alumni, students, and at first you could vote as many times as you wanted to. just like American Idol. Then we did, the final ballot was one-time vote, and anyone could vote, but it was a one-time vote, and Valkyrie won hands down. I didn't know what it was.
Joey, do you know of any other school that has Valkyries?
No, I'm confident. We get a lot of recognition. If you've seen Unusual Mascots, often we're named in those articles. You know, a lot of people want us to be the Converse Cougars. I just decided women's college shouldn't be. Thank you very much. It's been fun being here.